वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस सेशन आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर द टॉपिक इक्वेशन फॉर डैम्पर सिंपल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर। फर्स्ट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड डैम्पर ऑसिलेशंस। A particle will perform simple harmonic motion with a constant amplitude or energy of vibration, provided the restoring force on it is proportional to the displacement. In actual practice, we observe that if a physical system once oscillated, its oscillations die out with the passage of time. For example, if we oscillate a pendulum, the amplitude of vibration does not remain constant but decreases gradually with the time, and ultimately the pendulum comes to rest. In fact, when a body moves in a medium, frictional forces act on the body in a direction opposite to its movement, and the work done against the frictional forces results in the decreases of its mechanical energy. This is why an oscillating pendulum loses energy, and consequently its amplitude of oscillation becomes smaller and smaller as the time elapses. In the presence of frictional force, the motion of the oscillator is said to be damped by friction, and the vibrating system is called damped harmonic oscillator, and its oscillations as damped harmonic oscillations. The frictional or damping force on the oscillator arises from the retarding action of the pendulum. When a body vibrates in air or any other resting medium, the amplitude of vibration decreases gradually, and finally body comes to rest. Oscillations in which amplitude decreases gradually are called damper oscillations. Here in this case, the amplitude of oscillation goes on decreasing gradually. That is called damper oscillations. The oscillator whose amplitude in successive oscillation goes on decreasing due to presence of damping force or dissipative force is known as damped harmonic oscillator, where oscillator whose amplitude in successive oscillation goes on decreasing due to presence of damping force or dissipative force is known as damped harmonic oscillator. For example, a simple pendulum oscillating in air medium. And one more example is deadbeat and ballistic galvanometer and also LCR circuits. For this one, you can see the animated clip regarding this damper oscillations. See in the picture, see here, this is a simple pendulum. See how the amplitude goes on decreases here. Yeah, amplitude goes on decreases here. From here to here, see here, amplitude decreases here. If you oscillate a pendulum like this to and fro, the amplitude of vibration does not remain constant. Here the amplitude does not remain constant here. When it comes to and fro, it reaches extreme and mean position, and again extreme, again comes to mean position, again go to extreme. But in the previous, it does not reach the previous position. It reaches second extreme point. Then the amplitude goes like this, decreases like this. See the amplitude factors here. Here in the first case, maximum amplitude here. Now the amplitude gradually goes on decreasing like this. This is the decrement of amplitude of the oscillating pendulum. Gradually with the time it decreases. Ultimately the pendulum comes to rest. Ultimately it comes to rest. In fact, when a body moves in the medium, frictional force acting the body in a direction opposite to its movement. And the work done against the frictional force results in the decreases of its mechanical energy. This is why an oscillating pendulum loses energy, and consequently its amplitude of oscillations becomes smaller and smaller and smaller as the time elapses. Here the time period and this displacement and the time period, time of interval. As the time elapses, the amplitude goes on smaller and smaller like this. See in this animated clip how the amplitude goes on decreases in the simple pendulum when it executes oscillations. See. How the amplitude becomes smaller and smaller compared to first one, second peak, third peak, fourth peak, and fifth peak. Still, it reduces, amplitude reduces. See, like this, the amplitude goes on decreasing. Finally, it reaches zero when the pendulum comes to rest. The amplitude reaches zero. This is about the animated clip of damping. Now you can continue the topic here. See here. Next one is equation for damped simple harmonic oscillator. Consider a particle of mass m vibrating in resistive medium. In such oscillations, two forces act on the vibrating body. The two forces are, the first one is the restoring force proportional to the displacement y, and which opposes the increasing displacement. Minus sign indicates the opposing sign, opposes the increasing displacement in this case. Here, restoring force is equal to minus k1, where k is the force constant. Second force is a restoring force proportional to velocity, and which opposes the increase in velocity. That is, returning force is equal to minus r into dy by dt. Here, r, you can write the constant value or damping coefficient, or in some textbook they are taken as beta, in some textbook, other textbook taken as alpha, in other textbook they are taken as gamma. Here I have taken here R, small letter R. This is treated as damping coefficient, that is the resistive force per unit velocity. Resistive force per unit velocity, that is damping coefficient. Then these two forces are act on the vibrating body. Net force acting on the particle will be equal to the sum of restoring force and retarding force. Here the net force will be m into d square y by dt square, which is equal to restoring force is minus kx, returning force is minus r into dy by dt. These two forces are responsible here in such oscillations. Therefore, m into d square y by dt square, when RHS term comes towards LHS, then it becomes positive, that is plus ky plus r into dy by dt, which is equal to 0. Now, m into d square y by dt square plus k by m into y plus r by m into dy by dt, which is equal to 0. Differential equation of motion for damped oscillation is given by the formula. You know that this equation, this is m into d square y by dt square plus 2b into dy by dt plus omega naught square y, which is equal to 0. Here 2b into dy by dt, in the above equation, r by m is written as 2b. Here k by m is written as omega naught square. Then this is the differential equation of motion for damped oscillations. Let it be equation 1. Where omega naught square is equal to k by m and 2b equals r by m. Omega naught is called frequency of oscillations in the absence of damping. That is the frequency of oscillations in the absence of damping. Where B is called damping constant in the above equation. And 2B gives resistive force per unit velocity. Resistive force per unit velocity per unit mass. Per unit mass. Totally, B is the damping constant. Let y equals a into e to the power of alpha t. Y equals a into e to the power of alpha t be a solution of equation 1. A and a small a are arbitrary constants. Here in the equation 1, y is chosen as a into e to the power of alpha t. A capital letter A and capital small a are arbitrary constants. Then dy by dt equals alpha into a into e to the power alpha t, exponent of alpha t, which is equal to alpha y, and d square y by dt square is equal to differentiation of alpha into a into e to the power alpha t with respect to dt. It is equal to, while you differentiate this term, you got alpha square into a into exponent alpha t e to the power alpha t, which is equal to alpha square y, alpha square into y. A into e to the power of alpha t is y. Here it is y. Then it becomes alpha square y. Equation 1 becomes this equation 1, already derived in the previous slide. It is also shown that how it will obtain. Then this equation 1 becomes here alpha square plus 2b alpha dy by dt means alpha plus omega naught square of y. Here y is taken outside, which is equal to 0. This is equal to 0 here. We can substitute all these values in this equation 1. We get this value. Here when equating this one, y equal to 0, then it becomes alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega naught square is equal to 0. Therefore, for alpha value, you can just simplify this one, rearranging this all the terms when it comes towards RHS side, then the for getting alpha, you can put it the values in the under root square root, under square root. That is alpha equals minus 2b plus or minus square root of 4b square minus 4 omega naught square whole divided by 2. This is the value of alpha here. Here it is also written like this, alpha equals minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus omega naught square. Therefore, there are two terms, positive and negative terms are there, plus or minus. Here you can split them. Alpha 1 equals minus b plus of square root of b square minus omega naught square, and alpha 2 equals minus b minus of square root of b square minus omega naught square. Therefore, differential equation 1 has two linear solutions. Equation 1 has two linear solutions, and their sum is also solution to it. The general solution of equation 1 will be, here the equation 1 here taken here again, placed here. Then this equation becomes, general solution of this equation 1 becomes y equals a1 into e to the power of alpha 1 t plus a2 into e to the power of alpha 2 into t. Where alpha and alpha 2 are obtained here, the values of alpha and alpha 2 are obtained in the above equation shown here. Then y equals a1 into e to the power, alpha and l is minus b plus of square root of b square minus omega naught square written here, into the t term as it is, plus as it is, a2 as it is, into e to the power of alpha 2 values here, find out here. Found, that is minus b minus of square root of b square minus omega naught square into t. Now, on further simplification, we get e to the power of minus b here into t is common here in both the in above equation. Hence, e to the power of minus b t minus b into t taken outside, then it becomes a1 into e to the power of square root of b square minus omega naught square into t plus a2 as it is into e to the power of, here minus taken outside in this equation, then it becomes square root of b square minus omega naught square into t. Put it equation 2. Now, this is the displacement of damped oscillator. It is displacement of the oscillator, damped oscillator. That is why the displacement of damped oscillator. Let us see the different cases using this relation, equation 2, displacement of damped oscillator. See here, in case 1, for light damping, V is less than omega naught. When V is less than omega naught, in the equation 2, for small damping, we can show that Y equals A naught into e to the power minus BT into sine of omega t plus pi. This equation represents a oscillatory motion with amplitude A naught into e to the power of minus BT. This is A term here, replaced with A naught into e to the power of minus BT. And angular frequency omega equals square root of omega naught square minus b square. Hence, the effect of damping is to decrease the frequency. Here, when b is less than omega naught, angular frequency at its mean position, and the effect of damping is to decrease the frequency of oscillator. The amplitude decreases exponentially. Here the amplitude decreases exponentially with the time, and finally becomes zero according to the amplitude a0 into e to the power of minus bt. The a0 represents the amplitude in the absence of damping. This is the case where the damping, for light damping. Example for this one is ballistic galvanometer. Ballistic galvanometer is good example for light damping. The second case is heavy damping, which is greater than omega naught. The base greater than omega naught. For heavy damping, we can show that b into e to the power of minus bt, the sine of square root of b square minus omega naught square into t, where b is a constant. There is no oscillations and motion is called aperiodic or deadbeat. When there is no oscillation or motion in case of oscillations, when the body undergoes oscillation, when there is no oscillation or motion, there is no oscillation or any kind of motion, then it is said to be aperiodic or deadbeat. It takes long time to return to mean position. This displacement comes to zero exponentially without changing its direction. Example is deadbeat galvanometer. Pendulum oscillating in a viscous fluid like oil. Yeah, this kind of pendulum oscillating in a viscous fluid, that is already shown in the previous video clip, animated clip. When the pendulum exerts simple harmonic motion in the viscous fluid, then the oscillations goes on decreasing, amplitude goes on decreasing, finally it reaches mean position. Next one is critical damping B, which is equal to omega naught. Here in this case, we can show that C into e to the power of minus beta B into T, where C is a constant. This shows displacement decreases to zero exponentially and particle returns to the mean state in the minimum time. The damping for which the oscillation just stops is called critical damping. Here, the oscillation just stops, that is known as critical damper. The motion is neither over damped nor oscillatory and is said to be critically damped. What is critically damped? Example for this one is pointer galvanometer. Let us see the graph, variation of amplitude with the time. Here this is the displacement of the particle with respect to time, interval small t, second. Here in the previous animated clips, you can notice that the amplitude of the oscillating body goes on decreasing, 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 finally it reaches zero. Here this green labeled, green labeling, green color labeling shows the heavily damping. This is heavily damping. That is the first case which is derived and shown in the previous slide. And this one, here the amplitude goes on decreasing, decreasing, smaller and smaller. This is due to lightly damping. This is lightly damping. Here this one is red marked line curve. Red marked curve represents the critical damping. Here all these three types of damping, which is already explained in the previous slide in this topic. As you can go through these three damping definitions while observing this variation of amplitude with the time. This is about the damped simple harmonic oscillator. I hope you will understand this topic with animated motion pictures. Okay, dear students, will stop this one, and in the next session I will explain the topic theory of forced vibrations and resonance with some animated clips. Please keep watching. Thank you.